ओम शांति। टुडे इज़ योर 90th डे ऑफ योर ब्यूटिफुल मेडिटेटिव ब्लेसिंग एंड इन दिस ब्लेसिंग वी गोना टॉक अबाउट द गॉडेस काली और ऑल्सो नोन एज द डॉटर ऑफ शिवा। नाउ हियर वी आर ट्राइंग टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट वाई इज काली माँ और द मदर काली शोन इन ब्लैक। ऑल्सो वाई डज शी हैव सो मेनी डिफरेंट फॉर्म्स ऑफ वेपन्स इन अ हैंड। बेसिकली इफ यू अंडरस्टैंड God Shiva is a symbolism of destruction of all the bad within us, all the impure within us. So God Shiva, not Shankara, by the way, there's a very big difference which we learn in Brahma Kumaris, that Shiva is the incorporeal God and Shankar is the one who is remembering God through the third eye or the knowledge of being a soul and is sitting in tapasya of God Shiva. So Shankara is the corporeal, cannot be God. Shiva is incorporeal, is God. That's why when in bhakti we say Brahma Devtai Namaha, Vishnu Devtai Namaha, Shankar Devtai Namaha and Shiva Paramatmai Namaha. That means Shankar and Shiva are different. So here we are going to understand what is the essence of Ma Kali in reference to God Shiva. Let's understand. So what does Baba say in today's Vardhan? Baba says, may you be... So what does Baba say in today's Vardhan? Baba says, may you become a form of Kali. Form of Kali. Now, form of Kali means Kali has also been shown that Kalima is also a symbolism of Parvati and Durga. Now, Parvati. Vati is, par means something which is far away. Vati means the vatan or the place or the abode where I, the soul, reside. So this is also a vatan, the earth abode, the earth plane. And there's another vatan which is beyond this earth where we all came from, the Brahmaloka or the Nirvandham, that is known as a Parvatan. So I, the soul, am the Parvati who used to reside in that Parvatan, and I am the consort of Shiva. That means we say that you are my father, you are my mother, you are my brother, you are even my husband, and I, the soul, am your consort. That means you are my husband, the Lord of Lords, the husband of husbands. This is also known as God. So now, Kalima is also known as Durga. Durga means, the Durga Ma means, is a symbolism of removing all the Durgun in the soul. Durgun means the impure qualities and replacing them with all the virtues in us. So removing vices and putting back in all the virtues. Try to understand this symbolism. So Ma Kali is also known as a destroyer. She is the destroyer of the sins within us, the impurities within us, the wrong vision of looking at anybody, the wrong essence of listening to things, the wrong sayings which come out of our mouth. It's all happening because I, the soul, have become impure. So Ma Kali is a symbolism of purifying the darkness within and killing the demon within. Not killing demons as in terms of the human demon, but the soul itself has become demon within. That means the soul has got impure soul thoughts. That means ego, jealousy, hatred, comparison, competition, and many more things which have actually impurified the soul. So Ma Kali is a symbolism of that. Durga, we already understood that she removes all the vices. Parvati means I have to remember God, where I came from. Everybody has to go back Parvatan. That means the abode which is beyond. Par means beyond. So all these are interrelated. That's why Ma Kali is also known as the child or the daughter of Shiva, the incorporeal father. I am also the child of Shiv Baba or Godfather. So is Ma Kali also a symbol of anybody having those qualities who removes the vices from other people. Let's understand this in more details. So here Baba says, may you become a form of Kali. When do we become that? And destroy your impure sanskars, impure habits, sanskars means habits, with the awareness of your Shakti form. So Shakti means what? I am either powerful to remove my own weaknesses and all the impurities, or I am powerless. So that means Shakti. So let's go into details. Baba says, always keep this form of yours in your awareness, that I am the form of Ma Kali. I am a Shakti. So what all powers are there? There are 8 powers which have been put into the description. You can click on that. What are those 8 powers which we learn about at Brahma Kumaris? The 8 powers of the soul. For me, give you a small example. The power to tolerate, the power to face situations, the power to discern, the power to decide what is right, what is wrong karma, the power to withdraw from situations, to make the right decision. There are so many different powers. The power to put a full stop to your thoughts is also a power of the soul, which you learn in Brahma Kumaris as the form of meditation. So that's Shakti. Not even the shadow of an impure soul's vision can fall on me. I'm so pure. That's what is the symbol of Mahakali. So she was bloodthirsty doesn't mean that she was killing people around. Bloodthirsty means that she was killing the demonic thoughts in other souls and removing out all those things within a person. That's why the blood was removed. That means the different form of demonic thoughts were removed from that soul's mind. Not even the shadow of an impure soul's vision can fall on me. A purifier. I'm a purifier soul. I'm here doing God's work to purify the world. No impure soul can even have an impure thought about me. That means they can't look at my body or find me beautiful or handsome, because I am a soul. I'm focused on soul consciousness. So nobody is going to comment on my physical features of attraction or destruction, any form of thing. So they cannot have any impure vision on me. I am a pure child of God. So then, no impure soul can have an impure thought about me. I need to have such a powerful break. That means I myself have to put a break on my thoughts. If I am the reflector of impure thoughts, obviously those thoughts are going to come back to me. That's what is known as karma. Karma is not about just seeing or talking. Karma happens first through the seed. That means our thoughts have to be purified. First vibration of thoughts is the first karma which goes out, and it comes back to us. Always. It's so subtle. If any impure soul has an impact on me, it means I am not influential. That means I am not able to purify them. Rather, I am getting impurified. Those one who destroy anything impure themselves cannot become pray to anyone. That means I am the child of God, I am doing God's work, I cannot be impurified, I cannot be affected by anybody. Am I meditating early in the morning and making my stage powerful enough, strong enough, so that nothing impure can distract me or impurify me? Think about it. So become such a Kali form. That's where the destroyer comes. That even if someone has any such thought in front of you, of a malicious thought, he becomes unconscious in his thoughts. That means he's not able to produce those impure thoughts anymore. You are so powerful in your thoughts, with your vision, with your eyes, that those souls can't even think anything impure. You take the form of Kali and destroy the impure thoughts through your pure thoughts, not kill the person. That's what we have misunderstood. So think about it deeply and understand the form of Goddess Kali, the child of God, Father, incorporeal Shiva, the point of light. I am also a child of God. I can also take the form of Kali. And anybody with impure visions cannot stand in front of me at all. Think about it deeply. Meditate on this. And come back to me with your comments. With this, I leave you. Have a blessed day. Stay safe. Om Shanti.